Hey fellow tennis nerds, I hope all is well. Let's go into the pro player updates part 2. Yesterday I talked about a few different pro player updates. If you didn't watch that video, please do that as well. I did miss things as usual, so you were kind enough to loop me in, fellow tennis nerds, in the comment fields on tennisnerd.net, etc., on Instagram as well. So thanks to all of you who send me messages about pro player gear and stuff you've seen. First of all, Coco Gauff is now endorsing the Boom. The Boom MP by the looks of it, but judging from pictures, she's still using her speed. I think it's a speed with a pro stock code PT339 with an 1820 string pattern, kind of like a speed pro. So she's still with the speed and not with the Boom, but she's endorsing the Boom. How will Musetti handle the Boom situation? We don't know. Will he be endorsing the Boom and playing with the Extreme Tour, or will he be playing with the Boom Pro? He did try it briefly at the Next Gen Finals in one match, but he lost that match and then he didn't go back to it. So we'll see. Maybe he will just endorse it and that he will be one of the players to push the new line. One player that actually uses the Boom MP is Alex Bolt. Aussie guy, he was playing, I watched him today, but he lost a match to Juan Manuel Cerundolo, spraying balls. I don't think it was the racket in this case, maybe, but yeah, he was not in his best shape. But he's actually playing with the Boom MP, and one way to tell is that Morph Beam, which Yonex calls isometric, it has a little bit of a flatter profile up in the upper part of the hoop, so you can really tell that it's a Boom racket. Another player that has been switching frames is Thanasi Kokkinakis. Poor guy, he's been injured quite a bit over his career. He's very talented. He's beaten a lot of the top guys and had some great results when he's healthy. And now he looks to be healthy again, and he's playing well. He won his first match in Adelaide, I think it was, and he was playing with a new racket, a blacked out Yonex by the looks of it, a green butt cap, isometric beam shape. Is it a 98? Is it a 100? Is it a 98 plus? I don't know. But he seems to be playing well with it, and I've seen him in videos practicing with the Yonex before. So Kokkinakis to Yonex. I also watched Andy Murray. You might think I'm obsessed with Andy Murray, but I'm not. I'm just an old school guy enjoying Andy's fight back to playing on the top level again. And it's always interesting with players who are very, very set on their frame. He's been using the Head Pro Stock PT57A, the old Head Pro Tour 630 or 280, and he's been using that for all of his career, and now he's trying Prestige MP Lite racket, but with a different layup. So it's the mold from the Prestige MP Lite, but it has a PT57A layup, so it's a little bit different than what you can buy in the store, and obviously customized to his specs. But with that big change from 95 to 99 square inches, it's a big change, and he was getting more power on the serve for sure. That was very evident just by watching the highlights that I did today, but he was also spraying balls and he didn't look super happy in his loss against Facundo Bagni. So it was not the best Murray performance. I got some comments from you about Berrettini. He went to Boss, as I talked about in the previous video. He's also changed shoe sponsor. Before he was with Lotto as the overall contract, and now he's with ASICS shoes. I don't know which model, so I can't enlighten you there. Maybe someone here knows. Christian Garin, we talked about his move to the Blade. Is it a Blade? Is it an H22? Judging by the pictures, I actually watched some of the highlights from his match yesterday at the ATP Cup, and it did look like an H22 to me when I started the mold. It also said so in a Chilean blog. So probably the H22 in this case with a Luxlon string. He uses the Luxlon purple dampener. He's all in Wilson there. He is wearing Emporio Armani apparel like Fabio Fognini, and he's wearing Nike shoes, so he's changed from Adidas of the past. Fuksovic, he is now with Hydrogen, the skull-infested Italian brand. Thiago Monteiro used to play with the Pure Strike. He's now with the Pro Staff. Is it a Pro Staff? Not sure whether it's an actual Pro Staff or not, or if some kind of Pro Stock. But it's he uses Luxlon 4G strings. I also saw comments that Luxlon 4G is a softer string than Olopower, but if you look at the stiffness ratings, that's not really the case. Even Luxlon 4G soft is not the softest string. So 4G is a quite stiff string. So you can see here on the Tennis Warehouse University list of stiffness ratings for strings. And that's always a good reference point if you're unsure. That's it. Have a nice day. And don't forget to play some tennis.